today and a very, very welcome to today's conference, Jobs and Climate, Planning for a Future Which Doesn't Cost the Earth. Today's conference is hosted by Canadian Climate Change Trade Union Group, and we are also supported in our work and really appreciative of the work that the Greener Jobs Alliance have done to cooperate with today's conference, the Lucas Plan Project have done, and also Trade Unions for Energy Democracy. So we've collaborated on today's project, and I hope that you enjoy it. I'm going to introduce myself. My name is Suzanne Jeffery. Can you all hear me?
Yes.
Without too much echoey stuff.
Yes.
Great, lovely. So my name is Suzanne Jeffery, and I'm chair of the Campaign Against Climate Change Trade Union Group. I'm actually down to speak on this open opinion. We've slightly rearranged things. Only had one dropout speaker, which is amazing, and we've lost a speaker onto our final plenary, which is unfortunately Caroline Russell. Can't be with us today, so I'm going to move on that final plenary and chair the opening session, and that will also give us a little bit more time for discussion from the audience in this opening plenary. We've got some fantastic speakers to start off today's conference with. Just want to give you, just for a minute, just a brief kind of chronology of where the idea for today's conference came from. Hopefully you're aware of the work that we have been doing in the trade union group with the 1 million climate jobs project. We're actually 10 years, we're coming up to an anniversary next year, 2019. Yes, a few of us in the room are realising, no way, that long. So we're 10 years into the project of 1 million climate jobs. I would say I do feel we have made some advances in those 10 years. But the idea for today's conference came out of the election of Donald Trump and some of the concerns, not just that he was going to derail potentially the Paris Agreement, but more crucially was the way that he had run his election campaign and had pitched, unfortunately successfully, an argument to communities that have suffered greatly as a result of globalisation, as a result of neoliberalism, working class communities in America that have suffered ongoing job losses and seen a real decline in the infrastructure of the jobs and the infrastructure of the communities of those people. And unfortunately, he pitched an argument to those people that some of the reason why their jobs were being lost was because of interesting concern about the environment, that we're trying to close down coal plants because people cared about the environment, and he was able to position a jobs versus the environment argument. And in far too many of those communities, it had some purchase. It did convince people that this was the real choice, jobs versus the environment, and if you had to make that choice, you were going to make a choice for jobs. Now, they are false narratives. They are false positions. It is not jobs versus the argument. It is not globalisation versus protectionism. These are false choices. And unfortunately, there is an echo of some of those debates both in Britain and wider society in Britain and across the world and in our own trade union movement. And it was that recognition that we needed to really redouble our efforts to win a debate in working class communities within the trade union movement that jobs versus the environment is a false position. And that actually we can be at the forefront of tackling climate change that we are so urgently need, and we can be at the forefront of providing good jobs, meaningful work for people, which is part of the project of tackling climate change. And it's an argument that we do need to do. So today's conference is about unpicking that argument, putting it into the wider context of some of the other issues that emerge from the question of climate change, whether it be women on the front line resisting and experiencing climate change, or whether it be the creation of millions of refugees as a result of the impacts of climate change. So we're trying to put it in its wider context, but fundamentally that's the debate that we want to unpick. And hopefully end up with an emboldened and empowered group of activists within the trade union movement and within the broader environmental movement that will really redouble our efforts to take that back in to the workplaces and the trade unions that we're part of, and really aim this time to fundamentally win the debate in favour of rejecting that false choice of jobs versus the environment. So we're trying to unpick it, we're trying to empower people with a clear understanding of what issues are, and with some urgency about the work that confronts us. So hopefully that's what we will achieve in today's conference. I'm going going to go on to introducing some of our speakers, all of our speakers. Let me introduce our speakers first of all, and then we'll take people in turn. So to my right here, I have Professor Joanna Hay. I haven't got her permission to describe her in this way, but I hope it's okay, as one of Britain's, oh dear, what's she going to say, as one of Britain's leading climate scientists, which I believe that she is. Professor Joanna Hay works, she's co-director of the Grantham Institute for Climate Change and the Environment at Imperial College, and the work that they do is absolutely central to understanding the issues that face us and confront us around climate change. Also to my right over here, I'm Asad Rehman, who's Executive Director of War on Want. He was formerly international Head of International Climate at Friends of the Earth. I think any of us who are in the environmental movement, you know, will already know Asad for the work that he has done and the leadership that he's given within the climate movement and his understanding of that relationship between the social issues and climate change. And I'm going to ask Asad to speak shortly. Further over to my left, over here, is Sarah Woolley. Sarah is from the Bakers Union. The Bakers Union have been real loyal and important supporters of 1 million climate jobs. Sarah Hill is a full-time officer for the Bakers Union. She is from the Yorkshire region, but people also need to know that it is Sarah that introduced a key motion to this year's TUC conference on climate change and on energy democracy, which was successfully passed, and we're really grateful for the work that Sarah has begun to do within the trade union movement on this absolutely critical issue. Thank you, Sarah. And over here we have Barry Gardner MP. Barry is Shadow Secretary of State for International Trade and Shadow Minister for International Climate Change. He also has been a great supporter of some of the work that we have done, and we're grateful for Barry for coming along and speaking today. There are clearly, I would hope, I believe, I should say, many expectations and hopes in terms of what a future Labour government could bring to this issue, and we're also grateful for Barry for telling us today because it's Barry's birthday. So we definitely have a birthday from us, and I hope that this is a memorable birthday for Barry, and thank you for giving up your time today. There will be time for questions later on, but each of our speakers is going to do about 10 minutes each, which will give us a bit of time to take some questions from the floor. So please have a think about what you'd like to ask. We've got a microphone, we'll go out to take other questions. And we're going to start with our first speaker, and that's Professor